CrowdStrike has recently had an issue with a Falcon content update, which has triggered crashes on impacted systems. In this video, we will walk you through the latest dashboard release available for Falcon Insight customers to identify potentially impacted systems. It is important to note that this dashboard is intended to help customers locate impacted systems, but may contain inaccuracies in certain situations. Let's begin by logging into the Falcon console. First, click on the top left menu icon. Then click Next Gen SIM. Here, you will find a dashboard called Hosts Possibly Impacted by Windows Crashes Granular Status. Once this dashboard is opened, you'll find a list of filters at the top to help you drill down into your data. For now, we will just click on the CID dropdown and select an impacted CID. Next, click on the AID subset dropdown. You can either select all sensors here or look at a subset of your sensors. In large environments, selecting a subset of your sensors will improve the speed of results. By default, AID, computer name, product type, and status contain an asterisk to show all results. These can be used as filters if needed. Once the CID and AID group have been selected, click Apply to begin loading data into the dashboard. The dashboard will now return results. The first table is labeled Impacted Sensors by AID Subset and will automatically tag hosts with a status field. This field can be one of the following: OK, Recovery Very Likely, Recovery Likely, Verify, Down, or Unknown. For more information on these statuses, please see the article linked above. For now, we will focus on hosts with a status of down. We can apply that filter with the drop-down menu. To investigate a specific host, we can utilize the drill-down dashboard. Access this view by clicking on the three dots to the left-hand side of the table, then select See Host Details. This drill-down dashboard provides additional information on the status of the host. Endpoint details are given at the top, such as computer name, OS version, agent version, and more. Channel 291 activity identifies whether there is telemetry that indicates the sensor was observed interacting with the 291 channel file during the time of potential impact. Endpoint heartbeat check determines whether the host has been seen online for at least a period of 40 minutes after the impact window. Sensor heartbeat activity shows all heartbeat events received from this host both before and since the time of potential impact. No sensor heartbeats indicate the host has either been offline or unable to connect. Scrolling down further, we see user login activity, reboot activity, and a link to our remediation and guidance hub. Let's now compare this drill down against a device which has been remediated. The endpoint heartbeat check is stating that the device has been online for a period of time following the impact window. You can see this yourself on the right-hand side of the sensor heartbeat activity graph. The level of sensor heartbeat events has returned to normal. We scroll down and see the number of reboots observed is also low. Returning to the top-level dashboard, we can scroll down to see a second table labeled Hosts in Potential Boot Loop. You'll notice a status field does not exist in this table. We recommend sorting this data to look for hosts that are most likely to be in a boot loop based on the available telemetry. It's possible for hosts to be in both the top impacted sensors by AID subset table and the bottom hosts in potential boot loop table. Focusing on the columns to the right, we see average reboots per hour, last online duration, and reboots since agent online. Starting with reboots since agent online, this column counts how many times the agent has rebooted since it last successfully connected to the Falcon platform. Many reboots may indicate the host is in a boot loop scenario. Next, average reboots per hour displays how many reboots have occurred since the end of the impact time, then divides this number by the total hours to get an average. A high number is further evidence of the host being in a boot loop. Finally, last online duration displays the duration of time a host was last seen online in its last online session. By default, we're considering any sessions with an online duration of less than 10 minutes as potentially impacted. Once again, you can investigate hosts with the drill-down view by clicking on the three dots to the left-hand side. If you have any questions regarding the use of this dashboard, please start by reviewing the knowledge base article linked above. If that does not answer your question, please contact your CrowdStrike account team for more information.